A friend of the show right here on I'm Fired Up, the immortal Noble Beard, Jeremy B. Welcome to the show, my friend.
Hey, man. Thanks so much for having me. That's why they hate us, because if you get too many men together, you see what happens. You saw the boots we put on the ground.
That's right.
In D.C. We had over 1,000 Proud Boys show up there. That's our largest gathering in the organization's history.
Ladies and gentlemen, Noble Beard with the Proud Boys will be right back. Because we are blessed here at WTKN and Talk 94.5. I'm fired up with your host, Chad Thugzilla Caton, and I have the gentleman that was stabbed at the Stop the Steal rally. He is a Proud Boy, and he goes by the title of the immortal Noble Beard. Our listeners call themselves the Thug Army Patriots, and I'll walk with you wherever you want to go, bro. And I'll say it, and if all of you, any of you libs or people that choose not to learn about the Proud Boys as a club or whatever, come at me, bro. I don't care.
Yeah, I really thanks for don't. What you do. Thank you.
Yes, they do it with their fists. Yeah, they might throw a boot in there every once in a while, but we've had a couple country singers that said, I'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. How come that is a wrong thing all of a sudden? Why? Because it happens to go against BLM and Antifa? Guess what, Antifa? I don't give a flip. Come get some. One way or another, this country will stay red, white, and blue. And remember this. There's more patriots than there are of you. And the Proud Boys showed you at the last rally. I'm not doing it anymore. I'm an oath keeper. I remember my oath, and I ask every one of you elected officials to remember yours. And that's why we say here, show up, stand up, speak up. It's your republic. Fight for it.
Hey, I'm fired up. It's Chad Caton with 94.5, and I'm fired up. This is our first live here from, let's face it, Saving America. You can name whatever you want. You can call us whatever you want. But I'm telling you, you have not lived until you've seen the patriotism that is all over this place right now. No sign of BLM, no sign of Antifa. Let's hope it stays that way. We're getting ready to go into Freedom Park. It took a while for us to get here with our Uber. But I'm telling you right now, this is the last place I'd want to be Antifa or BLM. That's a fact. There are a lot of people here that believe in their country, and they believe that they were stolen from this election. And they're going to stand for it today.
County residents who were in Washington last week during the riot at the Capitol are receiving backlash back here at home. ABC 15's Annette Montgomery is live in Horry County after speaking to one of the locals who was in Washington. Annette, what did he have to say?
Well, Jennifer, Chad Caton tells me he was in Washington, D.C. on January 6th, and the comments he's been reading on social media has been hard to process.
A trip to D.C. for the president's rally has now created a war back home for Horry County resident Chad Caton.
I can't even comprehend the fact that I'm being called a traitor. I'm being called a domestic terrorist. I'm treasonous to my country.
And harsh comments on social media isn't the only thing he's been dealing with.
I know that there has been phone calls to my radio station calling for me to be removed.
Caton says the way some of his community members are treating him hits hard.
These statements that are being made, that of treason, of calling us domestic terrorists, Those are words you can't take back. And it affects people's lives to the point of safety and just our own mental capacity to go out and be a part of community.
Live in Horry County, Annette Montgomery, ABC 15 News.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I come to you tonight. This isn't one of my good announcements that I'm happy to announce, but I wanted to be in front of this prior to any of you finding out anything in another way. I was notified tonight that I have been terminated from 94.5 WTKN. I'm fired up on Saturdays, have been taken off the air, and the left won. So what was told to me, because I feel that you all deserve to know, is apparently last Saturday, 13 people contacted the radio station, and those 13 people stated that I was trying to insurrect violence into the street of off of my show by telling people that they need to become violent in some way or another. I then went to Washington that following Wednesday, where you've seen the fallout from myself, Angie Jones, the treasurer of Horry County, and Gene Ho, former Trump photographer. We have been called treasonous. We have been called domestic terrorists. I didn't have the station that had the backbone that I thought they did, and I was taken off the air.